Thank you, Professor. So I am back with more Python and more graphs. This time, let's scatter some data. I mean, let's learn how to build a scatter plot. We will compare scatter plot of SPY versus Exome and SPY versus Gold. So let's read this data and compute daily returns as well. As usual, we call getData function with these symbols and also compute daily returns. Next, we first plot scatterplot for SPY versus Exome. Kind parameter of the plot function of the data frame will help us achieve this. So we mentioned we need a scatterplot, but since the data frame daily return has values for 3 stocks, we have to mention which should be our x-axis and which should be our y-axis. As we are plotting SPY versus Exome, we assign x attribute as SPY and y attribute as Exome. Ready to see the output? This is our SPY versus Exome. Now let's similarly plot SPY versus Gold. Since we want Gold on our y-axis, we just replace the y label from Exome to Gold. So here are 2 scatter plots, SPY versus Exome and SPY versus Gold. But we want to recreate the graph that Professor drew. So we fit a line to the scatter plots. For that, we need the help of another good friend of ours, which is NumPy. So let's import it. After importing the NumPy library, we are all set to fit a line to our scatter plot. So we have a set of points and we want a line which has an equation of degree 1. So we go ahead and fit a polynomial of degree 1. This is what polyfit function of the NumPy does. So let's use it. We will first do it for SPY and Exome. The polyfit function needs x coordinates and y coordinates to fit a line. For us, the x coordinates are the daily return values for SPY and the y coordinates are daily return values for the Exome. The 1 denotes the degree of our function. Calling this function will return 2 things. The first is the polynomial coefficient and the second is the intercept. Since we have a polynomial of degree 1, it would be of the form y is equal to mx plus b. So m is the coefficient and b is the intercept. We name them as beta and alpha, just as Professor explained. Now we finally plot these values. The idea for plotting the line is, for every value of x, that is SPY, we find a value of y using the line equation, which is mx plus b. This parameter denotes that we want a line plot with a color red. Now let's check our graph. Here is the fitted line. Now let's do it for Gold so that we can compare them both. We also print the beta and the alpha values for each. Now let's compare the beta values, which shows how the stock moves with respect to SPY. You can see that the beta values for the Exome is greater as compared to that of Gold, which means that Exome is more reactive to market as compared to Gold. On the other hand, the alpha values denote how well it performed with respect to SPY. Numbers over here say that Gold performed better. Let's cross-check. You can see the upward movement of the Gold as compared to the SPY. One last thing is to find the correlation. Yet again, the data frame has a function CORR, which means correlation, and we can define which method to use. We use the method Pearson. It is the most commonly used method to calculate the correlation. There are other methods as well. Check the instructor's note for more detail. We get the output in the matrix format with correlation of each column with each other column. You can see that the SPY and the Exome are highly correlated. The value of the correlation for Gold and SPY is very small. Let's check the graph. You can observe that the dots do not fit the line closely, and that's why the correlation value for the SPY versus Gold is less as compared to SPY versus Exome. For more information on data frame scatterplot and polyfit, check the link in the instructor's notes.